Hey, how's it going? Back again with another Pokemon Go episode. Today is Sunday, it's currently 20 to 6. We've had a pretty action-packed day so far. Did a few raids this morning, ranging from level 2 to level 3. And also, a Walrein popped up, level 4. Unfortunately, my duo partner was busy at the time, so we couldn't do it. But I decided, because it was cloudy weather, I jumped in with my 6 Machamps. You're going to see that now. And see how well we did with a solo Walrein attempt. So after the Walrein, there was a Ho-Oh that popped up. Currently Ho-Oh is in the game for a couple of weeks along with Latios. So a bit of a mixture, you're never going to know who you're going to get. And I've done plenty of Latios, so, and I don't have too many Ho-Ohs, so I didn't mind doing it. So I headed down for my second attempt since it's come back. And did the battle fairly easy, we had plenty of players there. And went down, didn't record the battle. We've uploaded those to the channel already, but we did actually manage to get a shiny Ho-Oh, wow, which is fantastic. Pretty nice colours as well. IVs are terrible, we're never going to use them. Only if just loads of people for a raid, we can stick them in. But I'm sure it'll be as common as Lugia, so a lot more trainers will get them by the time he disappears. And hopefully we'll get to try and trio the Ho-Oh as well. We can definitely do it with the weather boost, and I think it should be possible as well with Brave Bird. So something to look forward to as well. So we also did Latios and a Ho-Oh again, some more trainers. Unfortunately no shiny that time, but I prefer not to get a shiny, just because I think it counts to bad towards you. I don't want to be getting too many because then I won't get the ones I want. So I'm just heading down now to do a level 3 Pinsir. Got some pretty good times on the Raid Times website and some very good ones. So I don't think we're going to come close to those, but we're definitely going to see if we can beat the other local trainers. Now we're going to jump in with our Moltres, Entei, Charizard. We did get a couple of shiny Charmanders yesterday, came out with 4, so we evolved 1 to Charizard. It was a female as well, which is quite good, much more rare than the male counterparts. And we evolved 1 into Charmeleon, just have 1 of each. And if trading ever comes out, we can swap the shiny Charmander with someone. And then, if needed, we can jump in with a Rayquaza. We're currently powering him up. He's not fully maxed yet. I think we need a couple more rare candies. So we're going to max him out. I think he's our 5th strongest one right now, just behind Groudon. And then we have a Flareon, and I definitely should have it defeated by then. So hopefully, do it with four Pokemon just to get a good time. I think the last time we did a Pinsir, I dodged a couple of times, probably shouldn't have. But we shall see. Also, there are rumblings that Adventure Week will happen this week. I'm presuming it's a week, so it's either going to start this evening or probably tomorrow when Niantic's marketing team are in and they can tweet and Facebook, etc. So I think for those we're going to get a lot more rock types appearing, shorter egg distances and new quests as well. So it's definitely going to be spin some new Pokestops, and we'll probably get some returning raid bosses as well, maybe Onix, Omnistar, and hopefully Kabutops as well, because we didn't get to do him the last time it came for, you know, only a couple of days. We didn't actually see one around, so just gonna pull up here and jump in with our Pinsir team and see how well we do.
Get lost in noise, seeking the truth in noise. You know the way of a route, so I will not get lost again. It pulls me under to resurface as a hunter. You see purpose in me, truly. I will not get lost again. I will not get lost again. Seeking the truth.